Hi everyone, it's Connor. I wanted to show you how to get started with NFC stickers on your iPhone. If you don't know what NFC is, it's a wireless transfer of data that you spread through just close contact. For example, this chip will send users to my website just by placing their phones against this chip. They can do all sorts of things, and I'm going to show you how you can get started on your iPhone without running any code. This one will take people to my TikTok page. It says open in TikTok, and it'll take them directly to my social media. All right, so to get started, you're gonna have to buy some NFC chips. Thankfully, these are super cheap. You might have seen those commercials for Popple where you hold your phone to the back and it takes them to their social profiles. That costed around $10 to $20. These cost 30 cents each. What you're going to do is you're gonna buy a bunch of these from Amazon. I think this cost me $10 for 25, which isn't a bad price, but you can even get them cheaper if you buy a higher quantity. I don't know specifically which ones are the best, but I'll include a link to the ones that I bought, and they've been working pretty well for me so far. Here they are. This is what they look like. Next, you're gonna need some apps. What I like to use is the Shortcuts app and the NFC Tools app, and this will let you read and write and run programs just by tapping your phone to one of these. All right, so let's get started by downloading the NFC Tools app. So we're gonna open the App Store, and then what we're going to do is we're gonna go to search and search NFC Tools. It'll be this one right here. There might be another one that does a similar thing, but this is the one I'm gonna be using today. So, the first thing you're going to do is you're going to press write. This will allow you to send data to an NFC chip so that people can use it. First, you're going to add a record. So there's a bunch of different options for things you can do. You can have URL and you can have people go to your link tree or your website just by tapping your phone to this. Let's try that right now. Let's do apple.com and we're going to press OK. Now what you're going to do is you're going to press write and it says ready to scan, approach an NFC tag. So we're going to press this here and it says complete. Now, what happens is when I close this and let's just touch it to here, it'll say open apple.com in Safari. That's so cool. So connect it to your link tree and then people already have access to all your social media profiles. Let's look at a couple more options on the app. We can do add a record and we can do social networks. Let's do Ripple and press it like this. Here's what's going to happen. Let's see what else you can do with the NFC Tools app. You can add a link to a file, you can do a phone number, you can do your contact. So if you want people to have your name and phone number just by tapping this. Next is a Bluetooth. Let's say you tap your phone to a speaker and then it automatically plays music on that speaker, kind of like the HomePod. You can also do that by adding a Bluetooth connection. That's just a really basic overview of the NFC Tools app and what I've been using with that app. But I'm gonna show you how to do more complex commands using the Shortcuts app. Let's go ahead and open the Shortcuts app. So under the Automations tab, you're gonna create a new personal automation. What you're gonna do is scroll down to NFC and it says when NFC tag is tapped to the phone, you're gonna press scan and add a new one. So name this tag, make sure the name is clear because you're gonna have a bunch of these. What you're gonna do is you're gonna press next. Next, what you're gonna do is you're gonna add an action. You can program it to do pretty much anything like a new tweet. You can have it log when you drink water and stick this to your water bottle. You can have it do more complex things. I'll show you this. I'm having it run a webhook where it'll turn my lights on when I scan this. There's an endless amount of programs that you can do on the Shortcuts app. You can go over to the gallery and look at some of the example ones that you can do. For example, you can have an NFC tag on your water bottle, and then when you press it against your water bottle, it'll log how much water you've been drinking during the day. I'm gonna show you how to set that up. So first of all, we're gonna go to the gallery, and then we're gonna go over to Essentials, Log Water. So you're gonna press Add Shortcut. So we're gonna do create personal automation, NFC, when NFC tag is scanned. I'm gonna name this water bottle NFC. Next, what we're gonna do is we're gonna have it run a shortcut and it's gonna be the log water shortcut. So we're gonna press next and done and let's see if this works. How many fluid ounces of water did you drink? We're gonna do 8. What I like to do is go to the setting, turn off ask before running because it's annoying and you have to tap run. If you wanted to have this control your lights, here's how you can do that as well. So you're gonna go to NFC. When you scan the NFC, let's go ahead and add it right now. Name it something. Next, what you can have it do is just search HomeKit and you can allow it to control your house. I don't have any HomeKit accessories. I have Amazon ones, but not HomeKit ones. You can have it turn on the light, refrigerator, or whatever that is connected to your HomeKit. There's an endless amount of combinations that you can do, and I'll include some inspiration in the description. So if you're gonna get some NFC tags for yourself, make sure you look at that link that I included so you can have a huge list of ideas of what's possible with your iPhone and NFC tags. All right, today I showed you how to use your iPhone with NFC tags to make your home more internet connected, as well as to make your life simpler and easier. Thank you so much for watching this video. Make sure you comment down below if you have any questions, hit that subscribe button. Make sure to follow my Instagram and my TikTok. Comment if you have any questions, and I'll see you in the next video.